It's a massive honour to be on the cover of Mixmag. I mean, kind of hasn't really sunk in, I guess. I mean, I've basically, obviously, bought the magazine for years and been into dance music for a long time, so it's, yeah, super cool to be given that honour. It's nice to get to sort of have some input into what we put within the article. I really wanted to be as open as possible, and I tried to think about things that maybe wouldn't be the sort of standard thing that a DJ would talk about. So we kind of even went to talk about like my favourite shops and things like that. I thought that might be different and possibly something that people might want to know about. That's, you know, a tiny bit sort of unusual, apart from sort of my favourite clubs or something like that. I wanted to be really open about how my live show works, because I think, because there's a lot of new technology that I'm using, I think there's a fair bit of confusion about how it works, and also I wanted to sort of show people what's going on with it, because I think it is kind of something that's exciting and new, and you know, I'm kind of interested to see people's reaction to what the stuff I'm using is. Topical at the moment. I mean, there's the famously recently Deadmau5 has been talking about this. He kind of weirdly said, "Oh, everyone's miming, but so am I," kind of thing. And I really have made an effort with the live thing, just to basically tell people the truth. Like, I use Ableton for the shows, but I'm also doing things like sequencing, sample chopping, playing riffs, all this stuff on the fly. So you know, it's kind of, for me, as live as I can make it while still keeping it electronic. My main thing with doing a live show like this was to, I really wanted it to be electronic. I love the sound when you listen to a track on record and it sounds super fat, and I love the beats being quantized, not being a real drummer, and it being kind of sounding kind of sloppy. So I wanted to do that, but with enough improvisation to keep it interesting and different. Cover CD was a case of really taking a kind of snapshot of my current DJ set, and it's kind of harder to put those things together than people realise, I think, because you're limited in terms of what you choose, because sometimes tunes are too new. You know, some dubs of other artists that I'll be playing on my set, they wouldn't want them, like, you know, all over a CD yet because they're unfinished or they're just too new. But I was really, really happy with the tunes that we managed to get, particularly the Skrillex track to open with, and it's been brilliant. I think it's kind of does really capture a flavour of what it's like to see me play. So there's drum and bass, dubstep, house music, and I really sort of was really happy with the way it kind of flows from start to finish. I just feel like in London, and when you play like smaller venues, you can kind of, different tunes suit different venues, do you know what I mean? And like tonight, I'd sort of think I might play a bit of, maybe a bit of old garage, some sort of new kind of garagey stuff. I just feel to play like a tiny bit more kind of deeper and more underground, whereas when you're at a festival, it's kind of a very, it's not such a discerning crowd, so you do have to kind of play some anthems to kind of get people into it, you know. It's just you kind of tailor your set to wherever you play, I guess. Thing is my next single, which is coming out in October. We just literally got its first play on Zane Knows show the other day, and that's called Tidal Wave, and that's with I did it with a group called Alpines, who did the vocal. And after that, I'm working my album, which should be out early next year. I'm super happy to have done it, man. It's really cool. You know? It's nice to be asked to be on the cover of such an influential mag.